Here on the plains of Erlitou, a new town shall be established. The nearby river will provide plentiful quantities of delicious fish, and the fertile soil is ideal for bountiful harvests of nutritious wheat. Additional food can be imported from Hemudu or Banpaw as necessary. As before, fine ceramics can be produced at kilns. It has been said that wonderful gifts come in small packages, and so it is true with the tiny silkworm. This marvelous creature, when fed a diet of tender mulberry leaves, produces a delicate strand of precious silk. Weavers can then meld these fragile filaments into luxurious garments, which are already highly prized by the growing number of new elite. Your village, in fact, needs a special neighborhood reserved for a number of these prosperous citizens. As word spreads of the beautiful silk being produced at your town, do not be too surprised if a greedy neighbor asks for some samples.
Hey guys, welcome back to Emperor Rise of the Middle Kingdom, and we're here on Erlitou's elite in the Xia Dynasty, and it seems to be an introduction to higher forms of housing. So let's go ahead and go straight to the city, and let's see, Erlitou's elite, what to do first. You are now tasked with building a new city from scratch, but where should you begin? Put the game in pause and let's look around. So we're supposed to check our mission goals, consult the agriculture ministries to see what we can grow, see what we can make in industry ministry, and check the funds available. It says we'll start with 9, but we're starting with 7,200 because we're on very hard. Look over the map and plan where things go. Yep, this is what I usually do. So this is its recommendation: common housing, elite housing, distribution, industry, and agriculture. Alright, so set up housing. It recommends using these grand way roads. Okay, and place a roadblock at a marketplace like that, I guess? That's a bit strange, but never mind. Then set up the fields, train a spy or send a gift. Keeping an eye on unemployment, clay and ceramics. We gotta get this going straight away, because I'm gonna guess we can export ceramics. Warehouses, dispatch a diplomat, pretty soon you'll receive a message of a gift of cash, okay. Music, hemp farms, remember the ancestors, alright, don't forget that. Right click the houses, request for silk, Hemudu will request some bolts of silk, okay. Warehouse tails, once your warehouse has some hemp, add a hemp store, okay, yeah. And from bland to plain food, we did that last time. A full mill, move to elite, and basically, there's big elite housing plots. Right, okay. And where there's a wall, there's a way. Make sure wall off the thing, and give them appetizing meals, silk. Does a marketplace have to be in there? I'm not too sure. Once your elite residents have silk and appetizing food, there's one last thing, they're like, see, acrobats, right, okay. Okay, I'm not sure if you have to put another marketplace inside this area. I think you do, but we'll see how that works out. Okay, so let's pause the game. And basically we can follow its the suggestions where the agriculture is supposed to be over here, industries down here, common housing, and elite housing. So first things first, let's go to the Empire map and set up our trade, because that's how we're gonna make some money. So let's open up, let's see, can I not do anything? Maybe I can't do it on paused mode. Okay, so let's set up our industry first then. So this area, it suggested building those aesthetic roads, these grand ways, like that. I guess we could go ahead and place that there like that, and drag that out there. I'm not sure if we have to do that for the whole thing, probably not, but let's go ahead and place down some common housing then. Now, I have been challenged to get 100% good feng shui while I'm playing, which means I can't build on these yellow plots. I will try my best to do that. I'm not sure how well that's gonna go though. But let's place down a whole bunch of housing because we're gonna need people to fuel our industry. Okay, so basically I'm gonna use this and set some stuff up, see how things look, and get things going. Alright, there we go. We've set things up. I put a wheat field over here for some source of food. You can see people coming in. Here's my common residential area with a market square, like it suggested putting it like that. I guess it'll work. I mean, they're telling me to build it like that. The mill's gonna go right there, and we got some clay making facilities over here, well, clay and pots. I don't have a warehouse yet because I kind of want to see if I can sell most of it. And then, actually, this one here is sort of blocking away, so... and then we got fishing wharves down here. You can see fishing quays. They're gonna bring fish up to this mill. So we'll have at least two types of food here, which should be good. Now let me put that, let's see, industry, workshop, kiln. I'm gonna put this kiln back here. So far I have gotten all of the kilns onto green areas, which is good. Let's see, where can I put this next one, which is green, but... Oh, what? A fire has broken out, but it's only been a short while. Well, never mind. I guess we'll let those burn down a bit. I guess. I do have inspector's towers, but I guess they haven't managed to patrol around yet. Anyway, that's the first fire I've seen. And we've got 100 people going. Good, good. So, oh! You put out the fire and it didn't destroy the building! You actually saved the building, which is fantastic. Alright, cool. So I didn't know you could do that. Alright, so I still need to replace that kiln. Let's see, kiln. I guess it can go at the end here, and I'll just extend this road out a little bit. There we go. So, let's go to the world map, and we gotta open up some trade routes, so now we can send a gift. I do have some. I'm gonna give a cash of... Ooh, I've only got 4,400, and there's three cities here. Well... I have history with Banpo and Hamudu, so I'm going to give 1,000 strings of cash to Hamudu and 1,000 strings of cash to Banpo, leaving me with not that much money left. So there we go, 2,000 strings of cash going out of the city, because we need a way to make money. So before things get on the way, let's build a warehouse. This is why I cleared the space here, but it looks like the warehouse has bad feng shui as well. I'm gonna put the warehouse there instead. And let's see, I don't want to accept everything here. I want to just fill it with ceramics for now. Okay, accept 32 ceramics, because that's what we're producing. Now, let's keep an eye on unemployment. 156 workers needed, damn. And these are not... Okay, the water guy is going around, evolving these houses. And there is some room for... Okay, looks like I'm gonna have to put down a lot more houses here. Let's get people moving in. And that one's bad feng shui. And we can line here with houses as well. There we go. Lots and lots of houses. This one has to go like that. And then that's bad feng shui for houses as well. We could stick one more there. Okay, so that's going to bring in a lot more people, but I'm not sure if it's going to be enough. And our money is going to slowly be dropping until we get a response from these guys. But it looks like our emissary is almost at Banpo, so we should get a response soon. Let's just speed the game up. There we go. Appreciated by Banpo and Hamudu. Okay, now let's pause the game. Let's have a look. Can we sell things? They need silk and ceramics? Perfect. And Banpo needs silk and jade. Okay. So we can only sell ceramics to Hamudu for now. So I gotta set that up. Now, let's check commerce. Would it be here? Warehouse, shops, market squares, mills? No? Oh, I can't remember where it was. We have to open trading first. So Hamudu, right. Let's send a diplomatic request to Hamudu. To open trade, and I would set up a silk industry, but I really don't have money right now. So let's request a trade with Hamudu. Keep an eye on our employees. There we go, people moving in. I think it's just about fill up. We might get some unemployment actually. There we go. There's a lot of unrest in the city. I'm not sure why, and more houses are burning down. Perhaps I should. Keep things extra safe by building more inspector's towers. Let's see, inspector's towers, we can put one more there. And Hamudu begins trading. Good. So we should be able to build a trading post, which would be, there we go, trading stations with Hamudu. I'll put it right. Ooh, that's bad feng shui. Can I squeeze it there? That's also bad feng shui. That's bad feng shui. What do trading posts like? I kind of noticed that certain buildings like certain terrain tiles. Is this... Oh, trading stations like to be in open grassland. Right. It might be good there if I take out the trees. Let's see. If I remove these trees, can I get perfect... Ah, okay, it does like to be there. Okay, good. So... Oh, I removed the trees and it now likes being here. Ah, I see. So it doesn't like trees. Is it just trees it doesn't like? Okay, trading stations don't like trees. Fantastic. Which means, if I clear the trees off from here... Would it be okay with being there? There we go. So, trading station, ceramics, we want to sell this as much as possible. 12 out of 12, yes please. Oh look, a trader. Do we have anything to sell? We do. Okay, let's see how much money this actually makes. You there. Yang Ya Bo. Let's see how much money this makes. We're at 1,000 strings of cash here. And that boosts us up to 200. It's about 100 each unit. Okay, so we got some source of income going, but still not a lot. He's only got one ox. This guy's got two ox. Does that mean he can buy more? I'm not too sure. Are we feeding our people? We are, but the appeal of the... Oh, damn, I forgot. Temples. Wait. Temples. Ancestral shrine. Where can we stick this? It's bad feng shui over there. Okay, we're gonna have to delete a house then. To boost the appeal of the neighborhood, I might want to stick it right there and see if it's good feng shui. Get out of the way. Yes, it is. Okay, there we go. Let's check religion. They feel neglected. Okay, so I got a religious building in. Come on, get employees. You don't have enough goods in your city to pay homage. Okay, that's bad. Okay, here we go. I've gone into debt just a little bit because I'm making a little bit of money, so I can crawl my way back up with the ceramics. As you can see, I'm full on ceramics, but I think I've sold 12 of... Oh no, I only sold 4 out of 12 this year, and it's August. That's kind of bad. But oh, here's a trader to get me back in the white for my... No? You didn't buy anything? Oh, I guess not. But I set up my silk farm here. You can see these mulberry trees. They're growing, and I spent the money on these weavers as well to get things going. So I should get a supply of silk coming in, which is fantastic. These muggers are actually killing the traders, which is a bad situation, which I'm not sure how to deal with it because I don't have any military things. Watchtower, herbalist stall, wells, inspector's towers. I don't know how to stop these muggers. Is there any way to stop them? Your city is short by workers, hygiene's not good. Unrest. How do I deal with this unrest? I don't know what's causing the unrest. Is it the lack of entertainment? Music school, acrobat school. I really don't know. What do the people want? I've upgraded my houses and there's still a bunch of muggers going around and they're actually killing the traders, which means I can't sell my stuff. There are a lot fewer muggers than before, actually. So maybe it was just a time thing? There were muggers which were sort of going around? But see, there's two muggers right there. And... Okay, one disappeared. Then he respawned. Okay. So this trader's gonna get through, so I'm gonna make some money at least. But see this mugger here? He kills the trader. Which means I don't get things sold, and I lose money. But there we go, we're back in the white. We are making some money. He did buy quite a lot, actually. How much did he buy? Bought 8 units, which maxed out for this year. Perfect. Okay, good. So I'm not losing all my money, really. But anyway, once the silk production gets going, we should be able to get more stuff on the way. But again, I'm not sure how to stop these muggers. I mean, there's no unemployment. We actually need more workers. Maybe I should pay, slightly increase the amount I'm paying. There we go, zero workers needed. Hygiene bad, serious risk of disease. Maybe hygiene is something? Uh-oh, here we go. Gamer Zach, you three-headed dog, give me two bolts of silk for my festival for Nuwa at Hermudu within 6 months. I, Bai Gong Fu, have spoken. 6 months to comply for two bolts of silk? My silk production hasn't started yet. I should have known, it did warn me about that. But look, they've only just started growing the mulberry trees. I'm not gonna meet that six-month promise, I'm sorry. It's gonna have to be next year, really. Also, I should, just in case, don't sell the silk and just accept it into the warehouse. Okay, but I have started making a bit of money, so I should squeeze in another mulberry farm, honestly speaking. Where can I put it? I think if I extend this road out this way and put a roadblock, I could, I think, squeeze a road back here, and I could put in another silkworm shed right here, and just sort of stick it there, I think. And then I should be able to get the mulberry trees. This road is a little... I should do that. And mulberry trees. There we go. So we got another mulberry farm back there. It will bring the things down here, and we could put down not a silkworm shed. We want to artisans. Weavers. I could squeeze in another weaver or two. Put in two more weavers and see how that goes. Generally, the supply of the mulberry, the silk from the mulberry trees and the silkworms should supply the weavers for the rest of the year. I'm not sure why this one is not going though. Oh, if I miss building the building when the growing season starts, they actually... Oh, look at that! You don't have to wait until a harvest season to harvest all the mulberry at once. It's not like wheat here where you have to sort of harvest it all at once. You actually just sort of gather it as it goes. And there we go, we got a weaver going. We might actually meet that 6 month deadline. All right, cools. Uh-oh. Hey, Gamer Zach, you gibbering buffoon. Where are the two bolts of silk we demanded? My festival for Nuwa at Hermudu has already started and I still haven't received the goods I expected from you. If you know what's good for you, you'll send them now and with haste. So I'm having a bit of problem with employment because a few things. I put down this extra silk farm, which needed 12 people. And also I'm trying to supply two types of food, which kind of means we need another farmhouse, which is another 22 people. And also for these houses to evolve, they need hemp. So I had to put down this hemp farm, which needs 18 people. So I decided I was producing too much ceramics, as you can see there, so I deleted some of that. And also I was sort of oversupplying fish, so I deleted one of those. So silk is starting to come in. I got one unit. I still need a bit more time to produce another unit. But the mulberry leaves aren't growing right now, so that's kind of a problem. But if I can get some hemp in, what's the season? April. It's quite a ways away. So only by the end of next year can I evolve these houses. Alright, so I gotta speed things up and hopefully I get one more bolt of silk soon. Okay, here we go. We got two bolts of silk. Now, how do I send it off? Is it on the world map, Hermudu? Orders? Agreeable? Fulfill the city's request. There we go. Two bolts of silk. Dispatch goods. Yes, dispatched. Okay, good. We've sent it off. Whew. And we're not really making much money right now. We should start selling silk as much as possible. But ceramics is not quite holding us up above the water. We'll have to see what we can do. Okay, now I've got a big supply of ceramics, and the gods are unhappy. So let's go ahead and give some... Ooh, I could give some fish offerings as well. Ceramics are good, though. I got 12 in storage. I'm going to give a medium gift to Nua of ceramics and make the offering. And got to wait a while for Shen Nong. So I'm just going to try to keep the gods happy. Meanwhile, I put two weavers over on this side, which probably means I can get rid of at least one on this side. So at least this mulberry plantation, when it sends the stuff over, it just has to go there. I also built another temple here because, well, I don't know. I'm just trying to keep the gods happy. And also an inspector's house, of course. Let's build over here for the good feng shui, really. Okay, so gotta make sure the gods aren't unhappy. And silk's starting to come in, which means we should be able to sell it soon, so that's good. And it seems like we're still overproducing ceramics. We got way too much. I don't want to remove a clay pit, but maybe I should remove one... do I want to hold a festival? I'm kind of in debt right now, so I don't want to waste anything, so I'm going to say no. I'm going to get rid of one ceramics workshop there. And then our employment is good, but our wage is currently very high to maintain that. So hopefully things work out. I just need these houses to evolve. I left hemp way too late. Lesson learned, though. But keeping in the white is really tough. We got to get more silk going, I think. Oh, I know what I could do. There's actually a whole city. I have no idea what they want. Darwin Co. Let's see. I can't train a spy. I could give a gift of fish or ceramics because I don't have money. So let's go ahead and give a gift of ceramics. Maybe a medium gift of 8 crates, and that will at least open up and see what they like. Medium gift of 8 crates. Head back to the city, and that actually lowers our ceramic supply. We've already sold our year's quota for this. I'm not sure if I need to keep the production up. Do I need to rebuild that ceramics factory? Probably not. We still have 4 going, actually, so that's fine. Now, if I was on surplus on workers, I'd put one down. Never mind. So let's see, maybe they would actually buy something that we need. But okay, at least here we got our hemp and our wheat going again. Because our food supply, I need another wheat farm, honestly, to keep a supply of wheat going. I could clear out a spot for it. So okay, I'm going to set that up and just see how things go for this year. Oh, there we go. Oh, great, Gamerzak. Dawenko really appreciates your generous gift of crates of ceramics, which they sorely need. Okay, so let's see what they have to sell. Okay, they need ceramics. Okay, we could sell ceramics to them. Oh, this whole time I've been trading with the wrong people. Banpo, you're useless. I should have opened up with Dawenkao. They needed ceramics. Okay, they produce wheat and carved jade and hemp. Okay, I could have imported hemp if I had the cash, but okay, let's send a diplomatic request to open trade with the city. And I'm going to set my ceramics industry back up because we're going to need to sell ceramics again. And I'm going to put this clay pit back down. There we go. So, we do need more workers, but we'll be getting that once the hemp gets in. Which reminds me, I should put down that hemp shop. It's under commerce and distribution, shops, hemp shop. There we go. Once the hemp comes in, we'll get the houses evolved, and hopefully our money will become way more stabilized if we can start trading with Darwenko for some ceramics. Ah, there we go. Darwenko is ready to trade, which means we gotta put down our trading station with Darwenko. Goes there. Nice. And we can sell... Okay, there we go. Selling 12 of 12 ceramics, and that should get our economy stabilized. And looks like our production is going really nicely here. There we go. This guy's gonna go ahead and grab that. Okay, so I never actually studied how the movement here works. It looks like the trading stations go to the warehouse to grab stuff to sell, and then they bring it to the trading station like that, and then they store the amount that's to be sold within that year. Okay, so this works quite nicely. You got the silks there as well.
And looks like the mulberry season is still going. The weavers are going hard at it. And I think two weavers per farm is enough. You can see the season's over and the weavers are going to keep working on the silk, so we don't have to worry too much about that. There we go. Now we got two trading places, trading stations filled with ceramics and silk as well, and hemp's coming in, which means a hemp shop. Ah, there we go.
It feels like I've been pushing this load uphill all day. The higher I go, the harder it gets.
There we go. So hemp's coming in, which means the hemp shop's going to start working. These are going to move in, and I can lower the wages because there'll be more people to work once people come in. You can see even at the wage rate high, we need 42 people, which is not so good. And there we go. Attractive cottages starting to evolve. Room... is there room for more people? I'm not too sure. Room for 19? Oh, they're going all the way up to spacious dwelling. They're evolving from attractive cottages up to... oh, it needs more appeal to evolve further. Up to spacious dwelling. And there's plenty of room. Wow, okay. So now this looks more like a city to me. All right, nice. Okay, good. So, money's going back up as well. These traders have not bought anything because I think we've maxed out on ceramics. We've sold the silk though. And we've sold some of that as well. Okay, good, 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 good. Now, economy stabilizing. So, once everything stabilizes further and I get a bit more cash, then I'm going to prepare and see if I can figure out how to set up a nice high class area up there, but overall things are going okay. Oh, a building has collapsed. Right, that was a house. So I'll build that back. Actually, do I need to build it back? Yes, we do need a few more people. Okay, so I'm not sure why that collapsed. Maybe I do need another inspector's tower. I guess I'll just have two. Okay. Watchtower. What's a watchtower for? Oh! Remember when I was having problems with the muggers and stuff? This watchtower would have really come in handy. Right. Okay, that was my fault. Never mind. Anyway, I'm gonna try to place this herbalist stall there. And if I were to rebuild the house, I would put it over there. Yeah, Feng Shui is still good. Good, good, good. So I'm gonna sort out the silk industry, because I really do need a lot more of that, and see if I can get a nice supply of silk. Uh-oh, what the? Angry ancestors have summoned a river dragon to overtake the land. The great flood will cause much grief and destruction. Oh, wow, okay. That is a disaster I've never seen before. I kind of neglected the gods for a while, so I think a reload is necessary. This is completely disastrous. Wow, okay. Wow. And it lasts a while too. Actually, if I were to rebuild, it wouldn't be that bad. I've got lots of money stockpiled. Okay, let's just try and put things back the way they were. So, we got our fishing wharves. It didn't actually destroy things that badly. So let's clear this out. That was the... okay. Now, let's speed things up. It's not an issue of money because I've actually done well. So, Darwin Cow trading station goes back there where I'm selling ceramics. I had the fishing keys, which were here. And I had inspector towers, one there and one was there. And also, before I forget, I should check the religion tab. They both feel neglected. Let's give... oh, I don't actually have ceramics stored up in my warehouse. Let's give wheat a medium bushel of wheat. Contented. Okay, it seems like they like wheat. Let's put our industry back, which is clay pits. One, two, three. I also had... weavers. We needed two of those for this farm here. What else? I can't remember if I'm forgetting something else. Was this another ceramics manufacturer, I think. I'm not sure. I think I have enough of those. I should probably put down another one, though. So I'm going to put down another kiln. Oh, wait, no, that was bad feng shui. Let's put down another clay pit first. I should actually move this one over a bit. Get rid of that. Okay, come on, move over a bit. Okay, a clay pit there, a clay pit there. And I can fit in a couple more kilns on this side to boost production. Okay. And we still have unemployment going. Because I actually do have a lot of people. I put down a few more farms here, another hemp farm. Wheat supply seems okay, but hemp supply was sort of running low, causing some devolution going on. There we go, zero workers needed, and no unemployment. Perfect. So, that only costs about 2,000 strings of cash, which is fine. And I should keep a closer eye on the gods, really, don't you think? But now with the money back in, I can try set up my higher end area, which I'm not exactly sure how this is going to work. Let's have a look. Elite housing. And also the marketplace. Let's see, market squares. We have a grand market square. And that looks a little bit weird. I'm not sure, what does a market square need for good feng shui? I'm not too sure. Should I be, is it different? Let's check the market square again, a common market square. There's some good feng shui there. It looks like they like open grassland. But the grand market square, a bit too big there. Okay, so maybe I should just put down the elite housing and see what they ask for. Wow, there's no... Okay, there's some good feng shui over here. Okay, I'm going to put down the elite housing. Let's start at this corner here. Oh, build this home in a highly desirable area. Oh, okay. Let's start with aesthetics then. Aesthetic roads, grand way. Get this going then. I suppose that works. And let's try put down the elite housing now. This home needs one bale of hemp. Wow, just placing it requires a bale of hemp. Okay, so I need to really boost hemp production to get things going. Okay, so I'm gonna have to do that and then we'll see how things go. Okay, I got a supply of hemp in. Now let's see how this works. I'm gonna put down the elite housing. Okay. So this house cannot evolve until the appeal of the neighborhood increases. Okay, so let's just see how this works. I'm gonna get the basic stuff. So safety, I'm gonna put down the inspector's tower, and I'm going to put down a well. Okay, oh, you know, that was bad feng shui. So a well, well goes well, well goes well. We could squeeze it. I suppose it's gonna have to go there. Okay. So a well and an inspector's tower. So I'm just wanna see how this goes. And let me check the review goals. Okay. 40 people in lavish Sihei ones or better. Okay, let's one move in and see how it looks. Okay, here we go. Okay. The new year has arrived. You want to hold a festival? Yeah, go ahead. And also let's check our religion tab. Shen Nong feels neglected. Let's give him some wheat, I guess. Medium. Make offering. There we go. They're both contented. Now, let's see. This is a modest Sihayuan and needs the appeal of the neighborhood to increase. So let's go ahead and give them a large garden. Does that work? Maybe we need to put residential walls. Let's put... Gray walls? Can gray walls span this? No, it can't. I can sort of go around. Let's just sort of build it around like that. I'm not sure if this is absolutely required, but I'm gonna do it. Clear those trees out. Let's get that gray wall. And I'm just going to squeeze the wall around this side. And this should be okay. Okay, so we can do that. And we should get rid of these grand ways so I can actually build this gray residential wall over. There we go. I'm not sure if that inspector's tower I'll move it inside anyway. Inspect this tower. There we go. So, it's still asking to improve the appeal of the neighborhood. What else can we do? It's got the aesthetic roads. We could plop gardens across the way. Maybe we gotta surround it with gardens. There we go, let's just surround it completely. And it needs appetizing food. Okay. And how many people? Only 5 people are living in that. Damn. I guess we gotta put down... It asked for what? 40 people? Was it 40 people? Okay, I'm gonna have to evolve this first and see how much I can actually get it to do. But, a marketplace. It's hard to squeeze things in once you place all the decorations down. Let's see if we can get away with just 2 rows of gardens. And then we gotta get a marketplace, which means... I don't know if we need a grand marketplace or just a normal one will do. Okay, I'm gonna try set it up and see how things go. Alright, here we go. We've got a market square with appetizing food. There we go. Today's menu, sweet and sour fish. Sounds nice. I also built this acrobat school right outside here. And another inspector's tower, because just to keep that in check. I had to build it there because of feng shui. And it looks like if you... This inspector's tower got upgraded, right? And I don't know if it's because the aesthetics are nice, but it's sending out 2 walkers instead of 1. Which, I'm not sure if that's... Was that considered... Was that explained at the beginning? Let me check. Erlitou's elite. It mentioned building things on that grand way, right? First place 20 grand way along the end. Okay, it tells me to build a grand way to help the well evolve. Place the grand way road aesthetics. Oh, it's actually asking me to put the aesthetics so the well evolves. Adding some gardens around the inspector's tower should cause it to evolve, in which case it sends out 2 inspectors instead of 1. Oh, should also place an answer. Right, okay, so these buildings can actually be evolved using desirability. So like these inspector's towers, I only need 1 of these if I were to go ahead and surround it with gardens. Will they evolve? There we go, they evolve, and then they'll send out 2 walkers instead of 1. Oh, that is fantastic! It's not just an aesthetic thing. This is serving appetizing food now. What? Now what else? You need a herbalist? Okay. Let's go ahead and give you a herbalist. Where is it? Is it in the safety? Herbalist stall? Where's the good feng shui? There's good, I guess. Okay, give you a herbalist. Now walk the other way. Now what else do you need? Can't make improvements until they receive some silk. Okay, well we do have... I did set it to selling silk again because I needed some cash, but let's not sell silk anymore. And we can put down a shop. Let's see, shops. Silk shop. And I'll put it on the opposite end of the food shop because you don't want to stain your silk, do you? Okay, city needs a few more workers. 12, that's fine. Okay, so we got our silk shop going. Let's grab some silk, bring that back. Silk shops in business, and we're in Lavish Sichuan's. And there's extra room for 5. So how many? We needed Lavish Sichuan's? 40. Right. So, if there's 10 each, that means I need 4 of these buildings. Which is, why is the herbalist not making it this far? Can you make it? There you go. Okay. So I need 4 of these, but I could easily place them down, but the feng shui is not so good. I could place one there, I guess. Let's see if I can get 100% feng shui on this. I'm gonna try my best. Fill that with gardens. Let's see if I can build this elite housing there. And I could stick a road back there. It's not the most efficient design, but let's see if we can do that. And we gotta fit 1 more, which I don't know if I can get 100% 100%, what was that? Feng Shui. I'll try my best. Maybe I can, if I squeeze it back here, the Feng Shui might be a bit better. Let's see. I'll clear this wall out. Can I get good Feng Shui for an elite housing back there? No? No, not there. I don't know what the elite housing like. Huh. This is gonna be a little bit tricky. Maybe if... Okay, I'm just gonna try and move things around and see if I can get elite one more plot of elite housing to be good Feng Shui. But if I can't, then I'm just not gonna be able to. Okay, there we go, I've done it! that was a lengthy way of doing it, but look at that. I managed to rearrange the houses in this sort of convoluted way. I had to delete the wall a bit. But this setup, where they are, it's showing good Feng Shui now. If you see Feng Shui now, if I have a look around, the only thing that's in bad Feng Shui... Oh, right. I didn't notice that. That mill is actually... associated with wood. Oh, it actually tells you. That mill is in bad feng shui location. The whole time, I got everything in 100% good feng shui, but that mill is not. Damn it, I should have checked earlier. Deleting the mill now would be a little bit inconvenient, but altogether not the worst thing in the world. Food supplies are good. So, let's see. Where could I shift the mill? Perhaps I could get rid of these weavers. And if I put the mill over there, would it work? Let's see. Commerce and distribution, mill. Yes, it will. Okay, so I'm gonna set the mill up there. And I just wanna set this to empty, empty, empty. And set this to get... What were the settings here? 12, 8, 8, 12. Okay. So up this to 12, 8, 8, 12. Okay. And to make sure that is actually done properly, I'm gonna delete one of these elite housings to make sure things are set up properly. I gotta replace those weavers though. Artisans, weavers. There we go. I'll stick with three weavers for now. Okay. So, job vacancies could go unfulfilled. I've filled that up with food. Let's grab the clear button, clear that up, and see if I can fit one more weaver down here. Any good feng shui spots? There we go. So, now, if we check feng shui... where was it? Was it here? No? It was under aesthetics. Feng shui. That should be 100% green feng shui. Definitely possible to do. Look at that. Everything is green. Fantastic. Desirability looks good as well. And now I can put down my elite housing. And once that fills up with people, let's see. This one could do... Oh, it's 10. Okay. So this one's just got to fill up with 10 people and we'll win. There we go! Haha!
You have done well. With your guiding hand, the town of Erlitou is off to a most auspicious start. Fine silk from its talented weavers adorns the town's elite and is also making a name for itself throughout the region. Riches are flowing into the town's coffers.
All right, well, Erlitou's elite was surprisingly difficult to master, but I think it's because I'm still sort of getting used to the mechanics, and this is still the tutorial Dynasty, isn't it? Well, I managed to build some elite housing and I pretty much know how everything works, but what's in the next mission, it's hard to tell. Alright, anyway, that's it for now. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video!